Gerald.com. Gerald, I want to give you the floor now, you know, for the next 10 minutes or so, and then I want to get into some other topics with you to look at the big trends of 2015 and also looking back on the trends of 2014, 2013 that you unfortunately very accurately gauged. And in your trends, I want to get your take on Russia, because you were talking about that a few years ago. I don't lionize Russia, but as you know, they're really trying to destabilize it. They're trying to cut off their pipelines. They're trying to screw up their deals. They're lowering oil prices to try to bankrupt them so that then there'll be no competition. They can jack it up as high as they want, in my view. And a lot of mainline analysts, not just you or Dr. Paul Craig Roberts or myself, are saying this could lead to actual war. Is there no amount of hubris out of these Harvard mafia people that, though they act like miscreant weasels, are in control of the nuclear arsenal?
Well, they, again, you know, we're looking at who they are, and everything they do, they turn to disaster. There's not one thing that anybody could point to that says, look at the great job that the DC gang has done, whether it's in healthcare, whether it's in education, whether it's in military, whether it's in the environment, whether it's in food safety, go up and down the list. And before I go on, I want to also encourage all the listeners of InfoWars to support what you're doing, as you know that we do, and we advertise in InfoWars magazine, because you're one of the few people out there, along with a number of us, that are concerned with the truth. And the truth isn't abstract. I'll give you an example why it's not abstract. Begins with our conversation today about the CIA, quote, misleading. It's not misleading, it's lying. There's a lie and a truth. It's not about banks misleading or misdeeds. It's about corruption and thievery. So there is a truth. And when enough people support the truth, then the truth, as they say, shall make us free. So I really encourage everyone during this holiday season to do what they can to keep promoting your voice of freedom. And as we look at the whole situation of what's devolving and the bigger picture is that we see in 2015 is this is the year of the game changer. Look what's going on in the markets as we're speaking. All of a sudden, the markets are now under pressure. The Shanghai Index today lost over 5%. It's down over 2% across Europe. Again, what's going on in oil? Yes, it's an oversupply issue, but it's a lack of demand issue. Because when you go through all of the commodities, again, whether it's corn, whether it's iron ore, whether it's copper, you're looking at five-year lows. You're looking at a global slowdown. And the way they get your mind off the global slowdown is with war. And going back to Russia, how they've taught us how to hate Russia. And you well know we were on top of this. We saw it coming with the Sochi Olympics. Again, prior to the destabilization of the Ukraine. Hey, Alex, don't go to Sochi. Because if you get on one of those airplanes, watch out for those toothpaste bombs. Who can make this stuff up? I'll tell you who. A bunch of sick SOBs. Hey, Alex, don't go to Sochi. Not if you like animals, because they're shooting all those stray dogs. And don't drink the water. No, no, no. It's all yellow. Yeah. And hey, those hotel rooms, they're garbage. They started to defame Russia before it happened. By the time the Olympics began, America's perception of Russia was at a 1994 low. I'll tell everyone out there listening, you want to get into a good business? You could do it cheaply, doesn't have to make any sense, and you can make a lot of dough doing it. Propaganda. That's the business to get into. Watch out for those ISIS, fear and hysteria. All of the propaganda coming out against Russia, let's put this into perspective. Every week, if not every day, We keep hearing about Russian troop movements, Russian tanks, Russian armored vehicles flooding over the Russian border into Ukraine. Hey, Alex, have you seen any pictures yet? Nothing. They show us nothing. Hey, this world of selfies? You can't show us one photo? No, I'll tell you why. Because they're liars. They're sociopaths. They are leading us to war. The global economy is collapsing. Only a psychopath would want to put sanctions on Russia that only hurts really the Europeans, because we don't do that much business with them, at a time when the European economy is in the crapper. Oh, that's right. Unemployment in Italy? Yeah. It's at record lows. Yeah, over 13%. There's a look what happened today in the Greek stock market. Now you turn on CBS, Bloomberg, you see the little prostitutes come out there and say how there's recovery over there in Greece. They're out of a recession. Gee, wonder why the market's down 11% today. So you can see only a moron, a psychopath, and a sociopath would put sanctions on Russia now that Russians are putting sanctions on the Europeans. And who is it hurting? Well, it's hurting the small people in Europe. Yeah, the ones that used to sell product to Russia. So they're destroying the global economy. And when I said before, Alex, this isn't a throwaway line, that Obama, who's launched a war against Syria, that's dropping bombs on a sovereign nation, and you remember the line about that humanitarian mission? No, we're not going back in Iraq. No, no, no. We're there on a humanitarian mission to save those Christians on the mountain and them Yazidis. You know what a Yazidi is. I'm sure you got them all over San Antonio. We got to save them too. No, no. It's not all those bombing runs they're doing every day. And who's he doing it with? Doesn't even ask Congress. Congress doesn't even care. They're traitors. These people are committing treason. They're treasonous acts, and no one wants to call it what it is. They're treasonous acts of war. They're treasonous acts that are robbing us of our constitutional rights, of our Bill of Rights, and our money, because they make up things. One of the top trends, oh, by the way, we have decided, we selected the people for InfoWars to hear our list of top 10 trends, of top trends for 2015 before anyone else. They just went out to our subscribers as we're talking. We also had a conference here in Colonial Kingston this last Saturday. A video of that is also available, a 5-hour conference we put on. And people, if they go to our website, they can sign up to get that as well. But we selected InfoWars because these are the people of all of the media that's putting out to the people freedom of speech, thought, and spirit. No one is doing it to the level that you are. So we decided this is the one we're going to first. And going back to the top trends, bankism. People are saying this is a failure of capitalism. No, it's not. It's bankism. The banks are in control. And the person that's writing this story for us in the Trends Journal, and we have the synopsis out now, is Naomi Prinz, who, of course, wrote that great book, All the President's Bankers. So don't complain about capitalism. Four words killed it. Everybody knows what they are. Too big to fail. Brought to you by Henry Paulson, former CEO of the Goldman Sachs gang, now playing big roles as Frankenstein in a freak show near you. What else do we have? Hey, the grand manipulation. It is no free markets. Everything is rigged. We know LIBOR is rigged. Only to $700 trillion. That's right, the interest rates. But we're not going to punish anybody. No, no, no. They're just misdeeds, and they misled. So we'll only fine them. And the same thing with the Forex, the currency exchange of which they trade $5.3 trillion a day. On and on, gold manipulation as detailed and written in this issue by Dr. Paul Craig Roberts. Other big trend, price wars. Get ready for it. Here's something, this is going to go out later. We just started writing about it today. This is a headline. If these equity markets continue to go in the direction that they are, this is going to be a rocket that's going to knock Santa out of the sky, and the retail sales are going to plummet. Look what already happened with Black Friday. Came in on the red, didn't it? No, it didn't go up 4.1% as the National Retail Federation had predicted, down 11%. Now you pile on that, declining markets, fear spreading across the world of the overblown equity markets that were only propped up because of low interest rates and trillions of dollars of phony money flooding in. You're going to see a disastrous Christmas, which brings us to the trend, price wars. You're going to see 50%, 75%. They're going to want to unload the garbage that they have made in China at any price they could get rather than being caught with oversupply of product. You look at the sales, even at the luxury end, Prada's getting blown away one after another. So when you start putting these trends together, how do they get your mind off it? I'll tell you how. You saw what they did with ISIS. Remember, they beheaded those guys. Ooh, beheadings are bad. Drones away. Ah, that's okay. That's a clean blowout, man. Bombs, fine. But no beheadings, and the people buy it. They buy it like they buy 32-ounce phosphorescent Slurpees. You could sell them anything. So when you start putting the trends together and keep looking where it's going, you go back into the positive ones, like you said. The millennial generation, they are going to be ripe for retrograde. This is the only generation coming up where they're looking, and those of us that are old enough, remember that all our lives, the polls used to show, the future is going to be greater than the present. Not anymore. Now they look at the future, they say, Maron, it's bad now, it's only going to get worse. They're looking for a future that they're going to take from the past. Remember, the Renaissance in Italy happened after the Black Plague. 60% of Europeans were killed. They were dead. They realized, what are we doing wrong? So they went back to the past, a renaissance, a rebirth, a rediscovery, retrograde. They're going to take from the past and retrofit it for the future. This is one of the biggest trends that people should look into, because the millennial generation, they're not stupid. A lot of these kids are really sharp, and they know they're getting shafted. And they can see who the shafter is, and they know they're getting it on the blunt end. So, manufacturers, it ties into local. It ties into high quality. You will finding out in our research at music schools, these kids aren't going back to rock and roll. They're not going back to Louis Armstrong. They're not going back to Ella Fitzgerald. They're going back to Bessie Smith. They're going back to Django Reinhardt. Beyond, they're going back to Jelly Roll Morton. They're going back to the roots of America that made this country what it was. Anybody can complain, and I don't want to hear the stories. I'm very aware of them. What we did to the genocide of the Indians, the inequality that we did to blacks, I'm very familiar with.